Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2321. Frequency distributions are easier with the new Excel dynamic arrays. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jalen. Before we start today, I need you to make sure that you have dynamic arrays in your version of Excel. And the fast way to do this is to type equal UNIQ. And good means that we have that tooltip. If it has no idea what you're talking about, this, like equal foobar, see no tooltip appears, then you don't have dynamic arrays, and you need to click that eye in the top right-hand corner to go watch this video. All right, so frequency distributions in Excel used to be really, really hard. That video I mentioned before is one of my best performing videos because it's really hard to do. So what I have over here in column A are about 5,000 cells, random numbers between 1 and 1,000. And I'm going to copy those and paste as values. All right, so you, in theory, are already starting with a whole set of data over there. And then what we want to do is we want to create our bins. These are called bins here, the groupings of this data. All right, so less than 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. And while this looks great in the chart, the most important part is this bins array over here on the left-hand side. So less than 10, put in 9.99, or I guess even 9.99999. You choose how many 9s you want. And then 10 to 20, you put the next level. And for the very last bin, the greater than 90, we're going to call that the default. Don't put any bin there. That's the most important part, having no bin for your last entry. Everything else has a bin. All right, so to create the formula, equal frequency. The data array is over here in A2, so I'll come over to A2 and Control Shift down arrow. All right, now I'm not copying this formula anymore, so I don't have to press F4 right now. The problem, of course, is I can't see what I'm the formula where I'm working, so an awesome shortcut here is Ctrl+Backspace. Brings me back into the active cell, back into view, and then the bins array is this little array right here. Close paren, beautiful, we don't have to press any special keystrokes anymore. Dynamic arrays is just going to make this work, and you see that we get one extra value more than the bins array. So that extra value is the everything greater than 89.99. All right, now you want to see how this looks, right? Now there is a brand new chart type that will handle this for us, but unfortunately there's a bug. All right, so if you come here to the statistics charts and hover over histogram, see it's doing the wrong thing. So the fastest way to create a histogram is first choose Pareto chart, which is frustrating because it puts the bins as the most common first instead of the right way, and then go to chart design, change chart type, and then choose histogram. So that's really weird. Creating a Pareto chart first and then changing it to a histogram gets you this type of chart. Now, hey, look, just one tip. If you're not already starting out with your own data, if you're trying to create some data, so just so you can create a tutorial or show that you know how to create frequency distributions, rather than use rand between or rand array, this formula here, norm.inverse, we send it a random number, and then we ask for a mean of 50 and, let's say, a standard deviation of 13. 13 times 3 is 39. 50 plus 39 should get us up to 89. 50 minus 39 gets us down to 11. So what is it? 99 point some percent will be between 11 and 89 using that formula. So I'll copy that formula here and paste, Control V. All right, there we go. See, that's the kind of nice standard normal that we're expecting. And notice that there are some outliers, things above 90 and less than 5. They don't show up here in the chart. Press the plus sign and add data labels to show that there are, in fact, some out there at those edges. So, great improvement now that we have dynamic arrays. Frequency used to be really, really hard because you had to select the right number of cells and you had to remember Ctrl+Shift+Enter. All of that goes away. If you like this tip, please subscribe and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. My book on Excel Dynamic Arrays, just $3 for the ebook. Click that I in the top right-hand corner. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.